the way I'll sign a petition. I'll sign any petition you want. I'll sign, you know what? Yeah. I'll sign fucking anything.
$100.
$100. Yeah. You have $100?
Yeah.
Oh, no? Mm-hmm. Then fuck you!
Here's the fourth most popular petition on change.org. Help save the II from extinction.
What's that?
It's about, like, a mammal in Madagascar that is going extinct.
Yeah. The thing about these petitions is that you're able to be like, I signed the petition to save the II, so, you know, pretty much like a conservation.
Uh-huh. I mean, the next one, the only one I've supported so far, place a statue of Marvel legend Stan Lee in his hometown of Manhattan, New York.
Hell yeah. We don't need a petition for that, though, on the internet. That's the thing, is like, I feel like the change.org was created to be a lightning rod for stupid people.
Yeah.
I think they're data mining people, because you don't just sign it. You put, like, where you live, blah, blah, blah. They do with all those names.
Make it illegal for dogs in Michigan to be kept outside in below freezing temperatures. Guess what? That is illegal. It's called animal cruelty. That has 924,000
signatures. What if they have a doghouse? Some doghouses are pretty fucking bad.
Fucking, your dog's outside in the cold. I don't give a shit.
Next one, pass the Plastic Pollution Reduction Act. I think it's some California act thing. Next one is hashtag justice for Nugget.
Who's Nugget?
It's a dog that nicked at a 2-year-old and then apparently it's going to
What do you mean nipped? Like nipped its head off or what?
I assume just kind of nipped it. I mean, when a dog nips at you, it's like, oh, you know, I'm a 50. You better.
But you can be nipped.
I'm not
nipped. No?
Yeah.
You really got to come up.
Tuesday. Yeah, and I'm learning more than how to live. Like, save this dog that bit a kid. Save this dog that bit a kid. That's the other thing. So let's say your petition hits 150,000 signatures. What do you think? The game of thrones writers are gonna like get this and like, oh, 150,000 people don't like this season?
$50.
I just imagine them like that gif of Woody Harrelson wiping his eyes
with the money.
Money.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, you didn't like it? Fuck you.
Yeah.
Every time I hear Game of Thrones, I think of the South Park's floppy penis song that they redid. Here's the theme of Game of Thrones. Floppy penis, floppy penis.
Yeah, it sounds like a South Park joke like that.
Yeah, so when you. I realize the right to petition the government is a constitutional right,
so
but
that's
not against it.
So that's the only thing that I've ever seen any of these even remotely work on. Oh, hey, guess what? Amber Alert!
Yeah, you guys getting that?
Going off
I'm getting some. I'm siren.
Hey, guess what? Flash flood warning from April 30th.
Today. My phone's set to
May
20th,
yeah, here we go. Here we go.
Yeah, the Amber Alerts and shit overrule that.
Flash flood warning in this area till 2:45 a.m.
Stretching her out.
Oh, sucks to be you guys. You should really turn that off.
My phone, you cannot turn it off.
You can't? You can't opt out of that shit?
Nope.
That should be illegal.
Nope.
Yeah, I'm opted out of all those things.
So the one thing is, I guess, the White House... is apparently...
Whitehouse.org has one, and if it gets to a certain threshold, the White House responds.
They have to respond.
But that's it.
Yeah, that's it.
They just have to be like, hey, we got your petition where you think we should send a dog to live on the moon.
Yeah. We'll get to that. Yeah, we'll get on that.
Yeah, I agree the White House is racist, that it's a White House instead of a multicultural house.
Yeah, man. Screw
me. But, I really don't know what you want us to do about that, so you guys have a good day.
We're going
to
paint, your petition to paint the White House every possible skin tone, every possible hue of flesh. Yeah, we're not going to do that. We're not going to have a meat house.
Sorry, this petition to add two spherical pavilions outside the Washington Monument. we are not going to do that. We'd also like to respond to this petition saying that the museums about George Washington should mention the fact that he has four dicks.
Uh-huh.
We're not putting that in museums.
He's a quad.
Yeah. Well, they were on a split too, which is that's the weird part.
Yeah.
We got this petition that says that Donald Trump should resign. And he's not going to do that.
No, he's not. He is the last person that would resign. If anyone would go that far, then it's that.
Sign petitions and we'll talk about them if they get a billion signatures. Will, because the other thing is, so say this, the thing about petitions for the government, right? It has to be registered voter. So that's why I used to, when they asked me, I said, if I'm not registered voter, I said, but these online ones, it's just like you made it if you're a citizen of the world. I want you to redo the last season of Game of Thrones. I'm gonna sign that petition. But you know, my opinion is worth it, but I've never watched Game of Thrones. So I'm just telling you.
How many did you say? 100,000 or something?
Sure, at least. Yeah.
No, it was only 100 millions of people.
Ooh, that was a big thing. It was a big thing. Oh, that particular mic's probably not top five. That's a good issue, Tim. I'd like to petition you to
I'd like to because whoever made these wide punch Twizzler brand.
Yeah.
Twizzlers are, I don't think they are. These wide punch ones not very good.
They don't really taste like fine punch.
It tastes like regular Twizzlers or the little sour. So I'm gonna petition this KLN Food Group to
make
their wine punch quiz.
I'm gonna sign that with this piece of wine punch.
Good.
Yeah,
I have cancer, but instead of going and getting chemotherapy, which is 80% chance of working, I'm going to rub these mint leaves on my nipples. And the spearmint tingliness should make my nipples hard and get my breast cancer go away.
It's versus take two of these and call me in the morning, though. I mean, that's how medicine does.
I mean, that and you know, has let us live longer and longer lives and cured many, many diseases. Now I realize that the reason why we have medicine is because the Jew bankers want to live forever.
It's a joke, by the way.
I got Tim giving
up. Oh, man. Oh, gosh.
Yeah, it's just hurt floating out there.
But you know what? Medicine... It kind of works. Like, have you ever had an infection and taken some antibiotics?
Sure.
But what about instead of that, you took some mud and you mixed it with magical dust
from a
and then rubbed it on yourself instead?
Uh-huh.
You think that's going to heal your infection?
Well, so my experience with homeopathy is that you go to Little Jamaica in Queens, or in Harlem. You go to Little Jamaica, and you have the lady there mix you up some stuff, and then you taste it all over your body, and you get Luke Cage powers.
I thought you were going to say it was on the Black Panther.
That was a good one.
The homeopathy is taking over more and more, and it's like, it's part of this anti-science movement.
Yes, anti-intellectual.
It's intellectual. It's like, oh yeah, we don't believe in vaccines. We think those cause autism despite zero evidence, and we're going to do homeopathic treatments on things. And like,
yeah, I would rather my kids get measles than have to deal with an autistic kid. I would rather my kid die of a horrible disease than have to deal with an autistic kid.
Yeah. That's basically what it comes down to. And the other thing about it is that, like, you can't... We've all heard the stories about, like, who was it? It was Jim Henson. He died because he wouldn't get a blood transfusion. Because he's a Jehovah's Witness.
Yeah.
And then, like, reasonable people that aren't members of cults are following this homeopathy, and like, they'll recommend the stuff to you. I had a headache the other day, and I said I was going to take some ibuprofen.
Yeah, yeah.
And someone was like, oh, you shouldn't do that because it's bad for your liver. Yeah, but it makes my head stop hurting now. So my liver being dead in the future. Like, no, you know, you can get, like, some herbal teas, and that'll you know, cure your headache.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm sure they will, but I have to go find some herbal teas, and I've got a big fucking bottle of ibuprofen on my desk. So I'm going to go ahead and stick with that.
The NSAIDs will mess you up eventually.
That's like formal use.
Yeah, but if you take six a day, every day.
Yeah, it happens to my dad.
I take four ibuprofen at a time, like, twice a month.
So, yeah, if that.
It annoys me that people think that they know better than science. Homeopathy especially, because it's like, even if you believe in homeopathy, if you look at the details about it,
does that not seem fishy
to you that they are taking a thing and they're diluting it down to 1/10,000?
But it's not like it's some special thing.
Yeah, it's some essential oils. Oh, we've been giving you essential.
Thank you. Betty.
Oh, that's the, yeah, I hear that all the time.
All the time. Oh, yeah, you need more essential oil.
But, like, the thing that
that's an essential oil.
Yeah, but the things they're diluting are not, like, rare minerals. It's like, we're diluting cinnamon or something, you know? It's like...
Yeah.
It's weird.
And at the dilutions, like, it could be, like, anthrax. Oh, yeah, we put some black plague in this, but we diluted it to 1/1,000,000 in this water. And, you know, that'll actually cure your chronic diabetes. You don't drink all at once. You have to, like, the amounts that's in even a single drop of water is not even a single molecule of the black plague.
It's less than, like, the fluoride they put in water.
Exactly. And it's, like, what do you...
It's good, but it's not as much as the chemicals the government puts in.
Well, they are turning the frogs kids.
Yes.
And they do it to try and make us weak, and so that we believe in 9/11.
Yeah.
The homeopathy, I'm...
Essential oil.
Essential oil. And I was really annoyed. It's like, oh, yeah, you get this. I take this tea. And then, you know, what you could do is you make the tea, and you can then use it and put the tea bag, and I put it on wherever you have pain.
And put it, you can put it on your face.
Yeah.
So
you put the tea bag on your face.
And I was like, you mean like a poultice? Is that what we're talking about now? Like, well, no, but you also can drink it, but then you can, and like, so you're saying putting a hot thing on a point of pain will relax it a little bit? Yeah, but the herbs and whatever else in there, well, it also infuses in your skin and stuff like, you're saying a lot of words that sound vaguely sciencey, but all I can hear is I'm full of shit.
Yeah.
Herbs of sage.
Yeah, incense. And it's like, yeah, you could just take this. I see your eyes a little bit inflamed. I'm gonna take this tea bag and just put it on your eye.
Oh, great!
Make
I love
better.
I love getting tea bagged.
What's the food that cultured? What is it called?
Yogurt.
When you eat it, it's supposed to have positive effects in your digestive system.
Probiotics. That's it. Yeah. I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm not a scientist. I don't pretend to know things.
Uh-huh.
But I do know that diluting something to 1/10,000th of a part per a liter of water, that means it's not in there.
Basically.
Like, if I pee in the bottle, if I put a single drop of bottle...
Oh, there's more pee in the water that comes out of your sink than whatever is in that
particulate. If I put a single drop of pee into a 5-gallon bottle and then shook it up and let it, like, really marinate and then poured it out, about how much pee are you going to have in a single glass?
1/10,000. if that.
Would you still drink it?
No, because I saw you pee in it.
Yeah, listen, Kevin Costner.
But if you didn't tell anyone you peed in it,
yeah,
and said that it was good for you and that it would clear, it would cause you, it would cure your cancer.
Mm-hmm.
Sound like hot cakes.
Exactly. Hot dog water.
Hot dog water.
I mean, we talked about that before.
Yeah, that's what it is.
That's what it is. That hot dog water is home in homeopathic medicine.
Yeah.
Well, that's my issue, Tom.
That's a good one.
Well, this has been. Here's what I'm getting. I'm Chad Burke.
I'm Tim Hamburger.
I'm Doug.
Catch you guys next week.
See ya. One of those is a much better song.
Ah, there's that. $14.
Hey guys, it's John. Here's what I don't get. Allergies. So it's kind of like you're making an RPG, tabletop RPG character, and you give yourself a negative modifier, but you don't give yourself any positives. So.
colors almost line up. Not quite. Wasn't trying to. go take a video outside.
never enough brushes. What's up? I'll be up soon. that kitty, boo-boo. No, no, not me. Go get the kitty. Go get the kitty, okay? Go get that kitty. Go, go get him. Get him, Zoe. Go, girl. Get him, boo-boo.